Yo, what's up, guys? It's Chris Drew from Never Shy Never in Loveway Records, and you are watching. You are with 8747 Productions, Skinny Sumo.
Nothing is real. I know this because I made a deal with the devil. He told me that I...
What's up, everybody? It's Big Brian here with Chris Drew of Never Shout Never. See that right there? They're here in Salt Lake City. We got a whole entire crowd of people trying to get in the venue right now to see you. How you feel about all these people?
Dude, it's amazing, man. It's such an eclectic bunch, too. You know, a lot of young kids, a lot of older kids. It's like everybody's kind of together, though. A lot of parents, even, you know. And that's what I like. That I like relating with everyone because I feel like everyone, you know. I got a little bit of my mom, a little bit of my dad, a little bit of my brothers and sisters in me, a little bit of my friends, fans. You know, I'm eclectic because they're eclectic. You know.
That's good. Eclectic makes you a better artist, definitely, in all sorts of aspects and respect.
Exactly.
You said that as you're describing your music back right before we got on camera. Go ahead and describe it to the people if they're not familiar with you.
Well, we're kind of all over the place, you know. Like, I started out really young. This is kind of year 5 for Never Shout, and I started out very young, kind of like very pop sensible. And that's what kind of got us our start and got us our record deal, was the pop sensible kind of stuff. And as I've grown, I've gotten a little more alternative and a little more experimental. This last record we put out, Time Travel, which is like, I mean, it's a trip, you know. That's what it comes down to. It's a trip, and it's about traveling through time and traveling through my own existence and through past lives. And it's super trippy. But we're about to get back to our roots and make a little more pop sensible stuff. Make a little bit of country. Make a little bit of electronic. Make a little bit of grunge. We're trying to. This next record's gonna be 12 to 15 songs, every song a completely different style.
Cool, and you said that you've worked with Butch Vig, who's famous for working with Nirvana and some other big bands.
Smashing
like
Pumpkins,
that.
Yeah. Pumpkins. A lot of my favorite groups.
So what was it like working with someone who basically coached your idols?
It was chill, man. He was honestly like one of the chillest people I've met. He was so down to earth, so humble. And we mostly just kept ourselves and did our part. And, you know, I'm hoping to get back with him for a song on this next record. I have this song Unwinding, or I'm Sorry. I don't know what it's going to be called yet. But it's kind of dark, but also has, like, you know, very uppity-up kind of vibe to it. So I think he'd do a superb job on it. So I'm trying to get back with him for that.
Yeah, and then you guys, you've been going in the studio. You have a whole bunch of albums and EPs out. What has to be the relationship when you go in with your engineer that you're working with in there?
Well, we did this last record in our last couple demos with our buddy Jeff Smith, who actually lives about an hour from where we live at home, which is Joplin, Missouri, Tornado Alley. We just got hit by a crazy tornado. And, you know, it's cool. We go in there, and it's such a welcoming vibe. He always has some snacks for us and shit. Hey! And, I mean, it's badass, dude. Recording in the studio is, like, it's just as much fun as touring. They're both just great. So.
And you guys bring around your own live sound engineer when you guys are on tour. What's your relationship like with him?
He's an old buddy of mine. We go back. I mean, everybody in my band and crew, we go back far. So my tour manager, he's been with us for about 2 years now. And he's just chilling. He's from L.A. He's actually from all over the place, actually from New Jersey. He moved to L.A. Now he's outside of San Diego. And he's just a really cool dude. And he keeps us kind of all in check, keeps the whole business aspect going while we're just having fun.
And that's what people forget, is that when you're in a band, you also are running a business. So what's it like being a 21-year-old entrepreneur and people out there, like I said, lining up for you? What do you think is the hardest thing that they don't understand that you do?
Nothing's really hard about it. It's actually really easy. I actually own a record label as well, which is under Warner Brothers Records, called Loveway Records. And I'm starting to sign local artists from Joplin, trying to build a local scene first, and then from there move on to... you know, a national scene, a national following with that, and national artists, and then move on to international artists. And I'm doing that all independently out of an office that I run in Joplin, Missouri. Whenever I'm home, I have a staff of about 8 working there at all times, and also have a studio of my own in Joplin as well, Loveway Records Studio. So it's easy, man. We just we have fun with it, and it's happened naturally. All I've had to learn is just patience. Everything takes time. You have to know what you want, and then you have to let time take its course, and it will happen.
So if you had just one bit of advice for students out there that are either studying music, they're studying, you know, engineering, they're studying, they want to do something like this, what's a word of advice you got?
Take advantage of the times, take advantage of technology, and take advantage of social media, because it's an easy way to get in touch with people that you could never get in touch with internationally, nationally, locally, everywhere. So take advantage of the times. That's what I'm doing, and it's working, and it's really fucked up how good it's working. So,
if you could do a tour with any band throughout history, who would it have been?
I have to say that probably like Led Zeppelin. Led Zeppelin would probably my go-to.
Good choice, I think, right there. Led Zeppelin. And then number two, if it couldn't be Led Zeppelin, then someone that's alive still, who would it be?
Bob Dylan.
Bob Dylan?
Yeah.
There you go. There you have it. So we're here again, Never Shout Never, and we thank you guys very much. And we're going to enjoy the show tonight. You guys should too. And we're here with Chris, Drew. Like I said, this whole crowd of you guys that are watching from home that are actually standing there right now while we're interviewing, but this is on YouTube. So Big Brian with Skinny Sumo, 8747 Productions, signing out. We'll see you guys next time.